Hello and welcome to Sports Gaming Universe channel here on YouTube. This is the Lando Lakes Madden 12 Superstar Series. This is episode 7 of the first season. Lando Lakes was first a Road to Glory character in NCAA 11, now brought in to Madden 12 for his pro career. He's now a rookie running back with the Carolina Panthers, and they move on into Indianapolis to take on the Colts this time around, as you see the Colts getting ready to take the field in front of their home crowd. You see this version of the Colts has Peyton Manning. He is not injured in this version, of course. So the Panthers getting ready to take on the Colts, and Lando gets a handoff out of the shotgun first play from scrimmage, at least for him, and he gets 16 yards. Nice carry to start the game. Lando, who's been having his struggles, has had some games that were decent, had some games that weren't so great. That's a pretty good start. Definitely he needs to work on upping his attributes in speed, and pretty much all the crucial categories. Here he's going to have a handoff to the right-hand side, going to barrel over one guy before being taken down. He gets another 6 yards there. So things working out all right so far on the ground. Here he gets another nice little bit of a spin there before he's taken down. Second and 5 on this play where he's handed off up the middle, met by 2 linebackers there and really just going to go nowhere. Brackett makes the tackle. We sim this forward and get the ball back. It's already fourth quarter. How about that? I believe this is before I put the quarter length up. This is the last game before the quarter length went up. Here you see a handoff to Lando again. The problem with the quarters here, oh, you see an injury here. The problem with the quarters here is that the simulation time just runs everything way too far off the clock. Lando running for another first down as you see them trailing 7-0 here in the fourth quarter. Trying to make a comeback against the Colts. He's going to get called again on 2nd and 13. Handoff, going to get him pretty much nowhere on that play, and we sim the game forward, and all of a sudden, game's over. So that's what I say about the simulation time. The quarters had to be bumped. This is just a ridiculous joke on how many chances he gets within a ball game, because you saw most of them. The Panthers lose 7-0. So kind of a boring game. Definitely the quarters will be bumped up from this point on. And it's time to move on to Tampa Bay. So you see, after winning 9 straight games and starting the season 9-0, 2 straight losses now for Carolina. They'll go into Tampa trying to right that and get back into the win column. And with increased quarter length here, as I finally figured out how to do it. I've had some of this footage recorded for some time. I figured it out quite a while back. But this will be the first game that you'll see that actually has the lengthened quarters. So right on into that. Tampa gets the ball first. They score first. It's 7-0. Hand off to Lando. His first attempt of the game. He goes up high, and the ball is knocked out. Not really sure why he went to the air on that play, but disaster strikes right from the first carry. He gives up the fumble, and Tampa comes and scores again off the turnover. So already 14-0 in the first quarter. Not good. But what else is not good? The blocking from this Carolina Panthers offensive line. Just too many plays here where the defense is allowed a jailbreak. Here's another one right at Lando. There's no chance to get any yardage on blocking like that. I mean, come on. We go to the sim again, a sim forward. Now it's 17-7 Tampa at this point in the second quarter. The simulation is still taking up a lot of the ball game. Here's a pass to Legadou Nene, who's going to go downfield after the catch and get the Panthers in business here. Just before halftime, Cam Newton finds him. So we're going to pitch to Lando to the right-hand side, and still nothing doing there. His speed could be better. That's something that's going to need to be worked on as well as others. But here again, you see an unblocked defender gets right up on him. Another thing I'm not liking is the play calling in this game. Here's a play that just is destined to fail. There's a lot of those. A lot of these shotgun draw plays. And if you're not going to block them, they're not going to happen. So Newton throwing to Greg Olsen over the middle this time in a 17-10 ball game. There's 33 yards to Greg Olsen. So a couple things happening right. Again, a linebacker shoots the gap. Bullock gets an easy tackle on Lando Lakes there. We need some blocking. Here they come off the edge, and at least Lando makes the first guy miss this time, but it's still only be able to get 1 yard. So Carolina does tie the game as this is simmed out. And into the fourth, Lando gonna truck through the middle for, again, he's got 10 rushes for 1 yard. How is that for a stat line? Insane. Last play of the third quarter, he finally does get some open field up through the middle for a first down. Oh boy, still has almost as many carries as yards. Look at this pass by Newton. Trying the screen, he leads Lando so far, it's thrown right to the linebacker for an interception. Grimm gets the pick. Tampa scores right after that. It's 24-17. And we've got problems here. So 10 minutes left in the fourth quarter. 24-17 again. Nothing doing for Lando. Just cannot get started. This offensive line. Well, here he bounces outside for a first down. Luckily, able to juke his way out to get that first down. 5.5 minutes left now. Hand off to the right-hand side, working hard up the middle. Doing the best he can, really, here with the blocking he's getting. Newton makes an ill-advised throw over the middle here, and McKenzie picks this one off. So two picks now for Cam Newton, not helping the cause. They get the ball back deep in their own territory and late in the game, and it's time to see what they can do. A throw to Geddes here for a first down. 4th and 7. They've got to go for this. They're under a minute. And Newton's going to heave it up deep down the sideline. He's got one-on-one coverage, and Geddes pulls it in. Are you kidding me? What a catch. Oh, man, and Newton's up over 200 yards, but those two picks killing him right now. Under a half minute left, he throws to the fell underneath, and look at this. He gets free somehow. A great block of field, and he's in the end zone. Are you kidding me? LaFell gets the touchdown from Newton. Did not look like it was going to materialize into anything, but it does. The game's tied, and then Carolina gets the 99-yard touchdown return on the kickoff by Gamble and win the game, an improbable win. Gerald McCoy, your player of the game, because he was all over the place with tackles and sacks. But the Panthers get the win. They're back in the win column with a 30-24 win. Next up will be Atlanta. Come back for that as the series progresses. See ya.